In the last episode, we blasted off the moon to begin our new life in space. But I immediately ran into two issues that almost ended our run, which would have been an unexpected tragedy. But on the positive side, it spawned an unplanned build that is without a doubt my most amazing and difficult piece of engineering I've done yet in the game. So stick around and check it out. Blasting off from the surface, I thought I'd be nice and efficient. Hit up the thrusters, get out of the moon's gravity as soon as possible, and conserve hydrogen fuel. That bit worked fine. But what I immediately realized is that I had two rather severe problems. One was that somewhere during the makeover of my mothership, I had completely forgotten to place any downward thrusters. So I launched myself upwards into space with no way to stop. This wouldn't have been so bad if I didn't have severe problem number two. Normally, if I had forgotten a thruster or lost one in a fight or something, I'd turn the ship around in some way so that an active thruster would face the way I needed to slow myself down. But I couldn't. The second human error was that I didn't have anywhere near the number of gyroscopes I needed to turn the mothership. From the time I landed on the moon, I had made the mothership around 4 or 5 times heavier with all my building and resource gathering. The ship could now barely be budged to turn. I was hurtling through space, generally speeding towards the Earth-like planet with no way to turn the ship, no way to stop, completely out of control. I was frantically scrolling my mouse across the length of the desk, trying to get at least some small amount of turn so the thruster could at least start a partial slowdown of my momentum. And I had a very small amount of success. I was still careening uncontrollably through space, but I was very slowly starting to slow down. It was just a matter of what would happen first. Without any control, I was in real danger of just slamming into an asteroid. There was also the Assert faction threat I was generating with every kilometer. As I moved through space, my movement was triggering enemy ships, and I could only hope that if they attacked, my turrets would be well positioned enough to fight back on their own from any angle. There was also the very real threat of the Earth-like planet. If I got too close before my ship stopped and I got caught in the planet's gravity field, without all my thrusters and without proper gyro control, it would probably end badly. Fortunately, I was able to stop in time without face-planting into an asteroid or the planet. But I did attract the attention of the Assert faction. They sent a drone at me, and my turrets did manage to shoot it down, which was good. The bad part was that the drone was flying straight at me when it blew up, and all the debris from the wreckage came smashing into my mothership and did quite a bit more damage than I would have thought. I guess that's one reason why homemade projectile weapons are still pretty effective. With the ship stopped and enemy drone smash damage repaired, I was able to add the missing thrusters and went about adding 7 more gyroscopes to my ship. I only had 2 before, so now I had a total of 9. It's still a bit sluggish to turn, but at least I can turn it. And considering it's a big, heavy ship, it has a reasonably appropriate amount of heavy turn feel while still being functional. So I'm good with it. At this point, I just piloted the ship to an open area of space that seemed somewhat close to several asteroids with resources and started my space station. Truthfully though, at this point, I hadn't really worked out exactly how I'd build this space station, and I did have options. I could get somewhat near an asteroid, build a long arm off it, and start building using the stability of the asteroid to serve as a stable foundation. Without that, if I just plopped a block in space, it would float around in the weightlessness of space as I tried to add to it. It would have been just a nightmare. I could also have turned on a setting for the game that's called unsupported stations, which I believe will treat free-floating grids designated as stations as if they were attached to an asteroid or planet, effectively freezing them in place. That would have worked too, but I decided to do neither one of those things. To create a more realistic space simulation scenario, I decided to take on the extra challenge of just building it in the weightlessness of space. What I did was to start building a platform underneath my mothership, and also started with locking the blocks with the landing gear of the mothership, so the mass of my mothership, along with its engines and gyroscopes, would help keep the whole thing in place while I'm building. Here's where things got really interesting. I laid down the first bit of platform by hand placing blocks, then used my welding drone to finish welding them all up. Now, when I've been talking about building a big space station, I'm talking big. This platform is the beginning of the floor for a giant hangar that'll fit my mothership inside with lots of room to spare for all kinds of other ships and even other stuff like a small grid ship building bay, that sort of thing. So this initial platform is 70 by 10. It was here that I got an idea, an absolutely wonderfully space engineering idea. I would build a kind of robot drone that would automatically assemble a wall to any prescribed dimension I wanted. To set and control the size, I'd take a blueprint of this 70 by 10 platform and use a projector to establish exactly where and how much of it I wanted to build. Right now, I was going to replicate the whole 70 by 10 several times, but I realized I could flip the image endways and make some 10 by whatever length I wanted, or show only 5 of the 10 70 block long stretches, or even make a couple different sized blueprints to use in a variety of ways. The build part of this automated robot I thought would be easy. A little rover-like thing could drive across the platform, welding up the grid, and use sensors and maybe some sort of pivot to turn the thing around. I was way wrong. The engineering challenges of this build just kept mounting. I needed something to keep it adhered to the platform because there was no gravity. So I tried a gravity generator and artificial mass blocks, but that truly created an odd bit of phantom force, moving the whole platform as the gravity generator pulled on the wall-building drone. It needed to know when to move forwards, because it needed to build another block. It needed to know when to stop. It needed to reposition itself so it could keep building the next layer. It needed to turn around or at least change direction. It needed to hold a lot of material. It needed to control its speed and not get bogged down when carrying a lot of material versus when empty. It couldn't accidentally place a part of itself inside of the block it needed to weld. It needed to control its movement without using any GPS markers and typical autopilot, because this whole grid could and would move. And I was going to have probably hundreds of ever-changing waypoints. No two waypoints would be the same. All the things I needed to do and overcome quickly went from a project I thought would take 2 or 3 hours to my most challenging build project to date, and wound up being about 3 weeks in the development and test. Now bear in mind, I do all these builds in survival mode, so all the time and resources spent would count toward the challenges of my playthrough. The number of iterations, trials, errors, and incremental improvement were really too many to go through in the video, but I'll give a summary of the progression. It went from something that drove on the surface of the platform to something that propelled itself with wheels along the edge like a rail, to something that skidded along the rail using thrusters, to something that would glide along the rail in a more frictionless fashion, and finally, to something that looked very industrial and cool. This wall builder is fully automated. Just fill it up with material, turn it on, and let it build whatever holographic wall you've projected. It also does it all with just vanilla sensors and timer blocks. No scripts, or mods. Even though the robot does a lot of turning things off and on and sensor checking, the short of how it works is this. You turn it on for a given starting direction. It senses whether or not it's at the end of the row by looking for large grid blocks. It moves by cycling between forward thrusters and backward thrusters, and lets a delay between those two things control how long a thruster burns before the reverse thruster kicks in to stop it. When it gets to the end of a row, the whole machine raises itself up one block, so it can start building the next row of blocks, and reverses direction to start the whole process over, welding and moving forwards until it reaches the end of the row. Rather than using the gravity generator and mass blocks to keep it in good contact with the welding surface, I use thrusters, gently pushing down. This just seems to work better, and by relying more fully on thrusters all the way around the wall builder drone, it also allows me to use its own propulsion to reposition it to a new build area, or even go travel to a connector to fill itself up. A lot of testing and refinement went into this wall builder, as well as giving it its industrial and slightly modern look. And it's proven itself to be pretty reliable, having made a good number of passes back and forth constructing walls without any hitches. And I've gotten to the point where I'm pretty comfortable just letting it run, completely unsupervised. This build works well enough where I'm putting it up on the workshop for you to download and further tinker with. Even I'm not sure I'm through tinkering with it, so you'll probably see more about it in an upcoming video, as well as get to see the premiere episode of the Long Dark playthrough. More Space Engineers is coming to reveal what's behind this overall space station's concept, give you an update on how the wall builder's performing, and maybe see if we can't get ourselves into a little bit more trouble with this assertive faction. Wish me luck. There's a lot of building to do.